the Otis Civilian Advisory Council joined together with a host of units of Joint Base Cape Cod to hold an annual event to honor all who have died in military service for the United States, and in particular, those with ties to the Joint Base Cape Cod community. During the ceremony, flower wreaths were placed by memorial stones encircling the large reflecting pool, honoring and representing those lost in service to the nation. The solemn event was marked by a touching speech from Lieutenant Colonel Timothy Skip Sheehan, commander of the 6th Base Warning Squadron.
On this day, we honor and remember those to whom we may never have had a chance to say goodbye, who we honor due to their sacrifice.
Major Jackie Morey, I'm proud to serve as the Executive Officer to the Adjutant General. Memorial Day gives us the opportunity each year to pause, a chance to reflect, a day that we remember our fallen brothers and sisters. If we do it right, we remember that wearing this uniform is a privilege. Too often, the day-to-day grind lulls us into a myth that this is just an ordinary job. It is not. We stand on the shoulders of giants. Putting this uniform on is the privilege of my life. If you wear our nation's cloth, thank you for your service and commitment. As your sister in arms, I challenge you today on Memorial Day to remember the legacy we inherited. Let us honor our fallen comrades with our integrity, service, and excellence.
Hi, I'm Trace Meek, the commanding officer of NAVFAC Mid-Atlantic. In observance of Memorial Day, I ask each of you to take a moment to reflect on the day's true meaning. Unlike Veterans Day, where we honor American veterans for their patriotism, love of country, and for their willingness to serve for the common good, Memorial Day is a more of a solemn occasion. It commemorates the men and women who died while providing military service to their country. Just like the 17 sailors who died aboard the USS Cole when the ship was attacked October 12, 2000 in the port of Aden, Yemen. The Corps Memorial, which stands behind me on board Naval Station Norfolk, honors our fallen shipmates while recognizing the crew who valiantly fought to save their ship and return it to service, which is true form of resilience. This is just one example. On Monday, we will pause to remember the hundreds of thousands of service members from all branches of the service who have died in military conflict, to include but not limited to World War I and World War II, the Vietnam and Korean Wars, the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. The day can be observed in many different ways. Some visit cemeteries and memorials to pay their respect. Some wear a red poppy in remembrance of those fallen in war, which is a tradition taken from the opening lines of a poem titled In Flanders Fields. Some participate in public parades of patriotic themes, or cookouts, barbecues. They all unofficially mark the beginning of summer. As you enjoy your well-deserved time off, please remember those who lost their lives and couldn't come home to participate with us, and understand the freedom we all cherish today can be attributed to their sacrifices. With the easing of some of the COVID-19 restrictions and as outdoor activities begin to increase, keep safety in the forefront. The Naval Safety Center's 101 Critical Days of Summer campaign provides great information to raise awareness and assist in the lowering of risks inherent with the most common off-duty activities. Keep your family safe. I join Rear Admiral Korka and Vanderlei in saying thank you for what you do each and every day to support us here at our NAVFAC team and our armed forces. Hoorah!